Hello everyone, this is Chris Assis and I welcome you to another online workshop. So today we're going to be working on musicality, breathing and posture. And the reason I put the different themes together is twofold actually. One is because I want to create a segue for our future workshops, and second, because I wanted to give you an idea of how to work with different elements when you are in need of time. So if you are setting up your practice, but you know, at that time, maybe you have 20 minutes to spend, or maybe even less, maybe 10 minutes. How do you put something together that you feel it is worthwhile and that you feel that you're getting things out of it? So this way, hopefully the video that we'll have after this workshop is done, you will be able to use it in two ways. One, to just follow along like we would do today, and the second way would be to, especially if you have the guide, the training guide, or if you have the Intelligent Tango course, it will give you this workshop will give you an idea of how to work with all the different exercises and elements in there. So how do you put together a practice that makes sense and you feel that you have not wasted your time? So, parenthesis, no practice is a waste of time. You still are getting something out of it, but sometimes, especially if we're in the beginning of it, we might not know how to make it work. So it is 11 already, 11:01 actually. So what I want us to do is, now that we're past introductions, I want to let you know that this is all the practices that we're going to be doing are based on the It Takes You to Tango guide to Tango Training. And you can find that in the Tango Shop of Bautanz. And there are multiple videos, a big playlist that you can find all the individual practices. So again, you can use each video separately and do one practice, one video every practice, or you can combine the different elements similarly to what we will do today. So how we're going to get started, I'm going to put a song on and we're just going to dance. If you don't like my song, not a problem. Just mute me and put a song that you like on. There's no instruction in this first song. It's just to get us ready. And then we're going to come back together and we're going to take it from there. So here we go. Play. Thank you. Pausing first. All right, so let's get started. Here we go. So what we worked on the previous time was the ocho cortado at the end of our practice was the ocho cortado. So I want to remind you what it is. Pretty sure most of you already know it, but I want to remind you that that step, so we can continue on with that, with the different variations that we can do on the ocho cortado, keeping the step as it is. So, okay, sorry about that. Give me a second. Okay. Let's see, something happened with Facebook technology. Okay, so let's get started. So basic step for followers for the ocho cortado. You go back with your right, forward, imagine you have your partner here, back with your right, forward with your left, forward, you pivot, you do a side step, cross, and then you come feet together. Yes? So, one more time, you go back, forward, you go on the, a little bit on an angle, slightly towards your left, here, around, so your partner is right here with you, right side, cross, and feet together. So the variation that we did through video last time was changing the one. So if this is one, we're gonna see this one changing, going one or one or one. So for leaders, before we get going, you can of course opt as an option, do your basic step, and you have one, two, three, your partner is coming towards your right, open to the side, four, five, you come together on six, and you wait for seven and eight. So let's see how we can move the step around. I'll do it once for leaders, once for followers, and you choose the step that you prefer. So here we go. This is variation number one on the ocho cortado. You have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Maybe you do something nice. Let's do it one more time, then we start changing. One, two, three, four, five, six. This time, you don't take your time with seven and eight. You go seven. You hold the eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. 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 And one. So we're back to where we started. Let's do it one more time. I'm going to be doing leader steps
You guys choose whichever option you like. So, side note before we do it again, notice that this is on the downbeat. We're going to see more rhythmical variations as we go through our workshop. So, leader step, followers, you do your step if you like. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And you're back to where you started with one going forward with the left. So
let's recap. Sorry, adjustment. Let's recap. You have one, you have the ocho cortado step not changing. It's exactly the same. Only that step, we change how the where we enter it. What is the one in the step? What is the number one step that we do? So also remember, this is on the downbeat. It's not the only way to do the ocho cortado. We'll see more ways. Let's go. Music. Pause.
All right, so let's now see another variation. So we did we did two variations. We did the downbeat variation where you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Second variation where you change the one around. The third variation is a very common variation that you have 1, 2, pause. 1, 2, pause. 1, 2, pause. 1, 2, pause. Very common. 1, 2, pause. 1, 2, pause. Yes? Now, the third variation, and we're going to put the music back on after this. The third variation is where you make it really slow. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, for example. But everything needs to be stretched out. So you need to pull out those tools from your toolbox where you expand in how you move. Right? Come back. And expand. So everything needs to be stretched out. So that's what we're looking for. So four options actually to play with. Four. Downbeat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Number two, moving that one around. Number three, very common. 1, 2. Pause, 1, 2, pause. And number four, going really slow and elastic. So really 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I'm going to put the music back on and play with all of these options. Maybe, try to match the song. That's the idea. Try to match the song and you'll see which one, hopefully you'll see which one works better every time. So here we go. Not this, of course. Here we go.
Acabó nuestro cariño, me dijiste fríamente. Yo pensé pa' mis adentros, puede que tenga razón. Lo pensé y te dejé sola, sola y dueña de tu vida. Mientras yo con mi conciencia me jugaba el corazón. Y cerré fuerte los ojos y apreté fuerte los labios pa' no verte, pa' no hablarte, pa' no gritar un adiós. Y tranqueando despacito me fui al bar que está en la esquina para ahogar con cuatro tragos lo que pudo ser tu amor. Yo no pude prometerte cambiar la vida que llevo porque nací calavera y así me habré de morir. A mí me tira la farra, esa pela muchachada, y donde haya una milonga solo puedo estar sin ir. Bien sabes cómo yo he sido, bien sabes cómo he pensado, de mis locas inquietudes, de mi afán de callejear. Mala suerte si te pierdo, mala suerte siendo solo, el culpable soy de todo, ya que no puedo
sorry. So let's carry on because we have a couple of things to tackle. So let's carry on. We're going to do a couple of more variations that we have available, and then we're gently going to make our way to something else. So here we go.
Let's see. So we did one variation that has like a quick, slow part. Not exactly though. We have like a pause right there in the middle. Very common. Now we're gonna again change the speed during the step, but we have like a syncopation. So it takes like milonga flavor, like a milonga spice, this step. So, ta-tam, pause, pam-pam, cross, pam-pam, step, pam-pam, cross, pam-pam, step, pam-pam, cross. One, two, step, one, two, or better said, and one, step, and one, cross, and one, step, and one, cross, and one, step, and one, cross. So that's another variation to work on. And you can see it has a very milonga flavor to it. So let's recap all our options. Option one, downbeat. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, you hold. Option two, one, two, pause. One, two, pause. One, two, pause. One, two, pause. Option three, you go really slow. And even if you do the embellishment at the end, that also takes time. Option four, we just did and one step and one cross. And one, step, and one, cross, and one, step, and one, cross. And then the last option, taking number one around on the downbeat. So let's put the music back on. We're just going to keep the same song just to feel a little bit more familiar. And have in mind let's go into that afterwards. let's add that last variation, and we're gonna play with that afterwards. Here we go. Oops. Thank you.
Se acabó nuestro cariño, me dijiste fríamente. Yo pensé pa' mis adentros, puede que tenga razón. Lo pensé y te dejé sola, sola y dueña de tu vida. Mientras yo con mi conciencia me jugaba el corazón. Y cerré fuerte los ojos y apreté fuerte los labios pa' no verte, pa' no hablarte, pa' no gritar un adiós. Y tranqueando despacito me fui al bar que está en la esquina para ahogar con cuatro tragos lo que pudo ser tu amor. Yo no pude prometerte cambiar la vida que llevo, porque nací calavera y así me habré de morir. A mí me tira la farra, el café, la muchachada, y donde haya una milonga yo no puedo estar sin ir. Bien sabes cómo yo he sido, bien sabes cómo he pensado, de mis locas inquietudes, de mi afán de callejear. Mala suerte si te pierdo, mala suerte siendo solo, el culpable soy de todo, ya que no puedo cambiar. So,
in order to segue into our other two themes, I want to invite you to play with how the capturing how the music feels. Now you already know the song a little bit, so you are familiar with somewhat with the changes. And if you're using your own song, that's, again, try to stick with the same one so you are a little bit more aware compared to changing songs over and over again. So try to capture the changes in the music and how that sort of the music invites you to move. So let me give you an example. I think you might have noticed that maybe I started, I can't remember exactly what I did, but maybe I started with I think we were at this moment playing with the downbeat, and it was a moment where we were doing one here, one, or maybe this was seven. So yeah, okay. So this was a moment, it was seven, I was seven here. And then there was a change in the music. And instead of carrying on that like normal, like you would do one, two, and do the whole routine as when we were doing the exercise, I changed to bum, 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 bum. Then there was another moment, I think it was on the sidestep, where again, there was a change in the music. And you take advantage of it and you go into something else. So that's what I want to invite you to do. See if that's not what I did is not the rule, but if you feel that there is a change in the music that you wanna capture it, do so. Don't stick with one option just because. So you can play, as long, of course, as you are respectful of the beat. And even if you miss it, it doesn't matter. You take a little bit of time, pause, and start over again. Here we go. Let's use the same song.
Thank you. acabó nuestro cariño, me dijiste fríamente. Yo pensé pa' mis adentros, puede que tenga razón. Lo pensé y te dejé sola, sola y dueña de tu vida. Mientras yo con mi conciencia me jugaba el corazón. Y cerré fuerte los ojos y apreté fuerte los labios pa' no verte, pa' no hablarte, pa' no gritar un adiós. Y tranqueando despacito me fui al bar que está en la esquina para ahogar con cuatro tragos lo que pudo ser tu amor. Yo no pude prometerte cambiar la vida que llevo porque nací calavera y así me habré de morir. A mí me tira la farra, esa pela muchachada, y donde haya una milonga yo no puedo estar sin ir. Bien sabes cómo yo he sido, bien sabes cómo he pensado, de mis locas inquietudes, de mi afán de callejear. Mala suerte si te pierdo, mala suerte si ando solo, el culpable soy de todo, ya que no puedo cambiar.
So you can see there is a lot of play in this. So the more you play with it, the more options are going to be revealed to you. So now let's change gears just a little bit. What I want us to play with is these different steps. So I want us to use, that's why we started with Yochipatada. I want us to use the two characteristic types of steps, not that those are the only ones, to explore further breathing and posture. So what we're going to do is identify the two kinds of steps that we used for the Yochipatada. One, normal size step. Better. One, two, three. Normal size step. For everyone, it's going to be a little bit different, depends on your height and etc. And then the second is the extended version, right? These big steps, the invitation for a big step. And I want you to think of three axes in your body, one going up and down, the other one going right and left, and the third one going front and back. So as we're going to take a moment to, you can hum, you can sing, you can do whatever you want, but you're going to use ah for going for this axis going up and down. We're going to use e for this axis going to the side and expanding outward to right and left, and then we're going to use oo to expand to the front and the back. You don't need to sing along, you can just hum, but that still has to be the different vowels. So ah with creating a dome in your mouth, e with being like a smile out, and then oo like creating like a tunnel. So here we go. When you go ah, you're gonna feel that you're going up and down. So ah, to grow. Let me turn this way. Let's go. We're gonna do two times of each. Ah. Inhale, and again. Feel this tremble of this axis. Then you're going to go to the right and to the left with E expanding out. Two more. E. One more. Good. And now we're going to go ooh. So let me turn again. And now you're going forward and back. Take a breath. Ooh. Two more times. Ooh. One last time. Ooh. I'm going to put the music back on. Don't feel that you have to go with the music. Instead, feel that you're using these movements and you're playing with how much of each you create in order to go forward step. And then when you come up, right. Let's do a couple of these together. No music yet. So start with up. What if you want to take your ah down? Right. So I want you to play and then see how much you need for each step. So if I'm doing a normal size step, I don't need too much compared to a stretched out step. Right. Same goes to the side. If you need a normal side step, you still have expansion, but it's much smaller than where you take up. So you feel that you're taking up space before you even take a step.
Okay, here we go. I think we need to go with something. Yes. Ah. Yeah, let's do this instead.
Hear my word.
Hear my words. Hear my tones. Hear my So it's not as easy as it looks, the truth is, because you have also the combination. It's not no movement. Hopefully you identified that. No movement is, okay. Something's happening there. No movement is clear, right? That, oh, we only go up and down or we go left and right. There is the transition. So if you feel that you need to, you can take your shoes off so you can work a little bit on these transitions with the base or having in mind our breathing. And we're going to put the breathing in there. So he can be a little bit more comfortable, especially if you were wearing heels. When we're working at this, you don't only want to be going up, but you also want to feel that you're going down. So that's one component. Goodness. Okay, I'm not quite sure what's going on there. Sorry about that. Okay, so going up, but at the same time going down. So that's one component with regards to combination. That being said, it is not helpful if you are pulling up from the crown of your head. So continuously creating this pull. It's not helpful because it doesn't allow for the suspension that we were talking about. It also feels a lot of work, and it is. And in fast transitions, it will create trouble. Also, you would notice that you can try it even if this is not something that you usually do. So when you pull up, you will notice that because of the hold around your core, the muscle hold, you'll notice that the breathing is inhibited. So you are not breathing comfortably. That's a very good cue that will let you know that you're probably doing something wrong. So if you just pull up from the crown of the head, that's a very common cue. You're creating extra work for yourself. Let's see how that we can release that a little bit by finding a different relationship. So if we use this and imagine the dome of your mouth is the top dome and is also the bottom. So when you create the you want a bowl at the bottom and a dome at the top, and the two are moving away from each other. So let's try together, and you have you have an energy that goes down and an energy that goes up. And you're not pushing into the floor, but you're grounding. Let's try it again. Release it. Shake. Take a breath in. And on your breath out, you go. Into the ground and up towards the ceiling. And let's do it one more time for each side. And of course you can be on 2 feet, obviously. So, and one inhale. When you exhale, and one last time. And now to relate it to breathing and posture at the same time,
we have the thoracic diaphragm, which is a dome, and we also have the pelvic diaphragm, which is a bowl. So one of the breathing practices that you can do that are very well known out there is diaphragmatic breathing. So when you're working on the diaphragmatic breathing, which we're going to work together, it works exactly in the same way that we worked with the off. So when you inhale, the two bowls, one inverted and the other one like normal, they come together. And when they exhale, they go away. They go back to where they were initially. So inhale, exhale. Let's do a couple more. I'm just going to come a little bit closer to you just to notice what that does to your posture. So here we go. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One last time. Inhale. And exhale. And release. This is not the way to breathe. This is just an exercise, by the way. But notice how much that changes your posture when you find this relationship between the thoracic diaphragm and the pelvic diaphragm. This is very important because this is the area where we connect with our partner. So if this area is locked, it's very difficult to connect. So that was one aspect. The other is going out. And again, if we go, let's just work with this, going out at the same time, out at the same time with an E. Expanding, so you're filling up the room before you set, right? But what happens when we are going, say, for example, from a back step to a side step? So we need to use this downward motion that we were working with on the along this axis, and then transition over to the side to go from an out. So let's settle over one foot. Let's do two breaths, diaphragmatic breathing like we were doing before. Find if you can, if you feel that your hand, the hands help, I think that can be helpful creating this image. So you have the two bowls going, getting closer as you inhale and moving away as you exhale. One more time, going in to close to each other and so as much as you go up, you need to go down. And let's try to focus our energy on going down more than up. So now, the supporting action is up. Before, the supporting action was down, right? You go up, ground yourself to go up. But now you hold yourself to go down. Let's try. You're still holding, you're not letting go. And this is how it looks from the side. One more time. So for the sake of time, unfortunately, I don't know how time passes so fast, but the same transition we need, of course, when we're going in this direction, going with the oo, and we need to go maybe to the front and then to the side, or we just go, it's the same transition, grounding, supporting from the top. Let's do it together. And here too, just like the two other ones, the one is the intent and the other is the support. So in this case, it was, the intent was to go forward. The support was coming from the back. Now we're going to reverse, and the intent will be to go back, but the support will be coming from the front. So here we go. We go down first. Let's do a couple more of these. The intent is to go down because we need those nice big steps. And forward. We're holding. Our support is from the top and from the back. Let's go. Sorry. So you have a constant flow between all three directions, and is one, it's not clean cut, right? So now let's do like a little square going back, side, front, etc. And I want you to notice how the body, in order to accommodate these, this fluctuation, it changes. It doesn't stay in one position. Once you feel that you're holding and you cannot create these shapes, you cannot create an intention and a hold, it means that there is extra muscle working to keep your body in a certain position. I know that you're probably working, coming from a different background, maybe you're working with a different style of tango. I just want to invite you for now, just for now, to see if you can let go of what you already know and try this just as something different. Yeah. Okay. So let's do a little square. Let's start two breaths, and then we do the little square. So we go, get settled. You can use your hands if you need to. Here we go. Two breaths. Settle over whichever foot you like. We're going to go down in order to go back, and then we're going to go to the side. So we have. One more time. I'm going to use the, you have to hear me sing for a little bit more. Here we go. And now try to go at your own pace without my guidance. Find your own breathing tempo and see how you adjust your body to go through the different steps. Here we go. Whenever you're ready. And you can make the steps bigger if you like. and feel that you're taking up the room before you even take the step. Yes. Okay. So I think we have a little bit of time for another song. Let's go back and see. We're just gonna use a tango song. I know. Okay. Let's do yes. And of course, you can wear your shoes if you like or not. Totally up to you. I'm going to wear them because I cannot pivot. So we're going to close with a dance. Try to use those breathing techniques and posture techniques that we just discussed. And of course, if you want to throw one of those ocho cortado variations in, go for it. Here we go. Let's hit play. Yes, let's do this instead.
Fui como una lluvia de cenizas y fatigas en las horas designadas de tu vida. Gota de vinagre derramada, fatalmente derramada sobre todas tus heridas. Fuiste por mi culpa golondrina entre la nieve, rosa marchitada por la nube que nos llueve. Fuimos la esperanza que no llega, que no alcanza, que no puede vislumbrar la tarde mansa. Fuimos el viajero que no implora, que no reza, que no llora, que se echó a morir. No comprendes que te estás matando, no comprendes que te estoy llamando. No me ves, es que te estoy llorando y quisiera no llorar más. No ves, es mejor que mi dolor quede tirado con tu amor, liberado de mi amor final. No comprendes que te estoy salvando, no comprendes que te estás matando. No me sigas, ni me llames, ni me beses, ni me llores, ni me quieras más. Es mejor que mi dolor que he tirado con tu amor, liberado de mi amor final. No comprendes que te estoy salvando, no comprendes que te estoy amando. No me sigas, ni me llames, ni me beses, ni me llores, ni me quieras más.
Okay. Facebook doesn't seem to like me today. All right. Okay, so we have officially reached the end. Thank you very much for joining. I apologize for all the craziness. Apparently, some ad breaks. So something to do with the audio, I'm guessing. We'll find a better way for next time.
Okay, now it's stopping me as well. Okay, interesting. So anyways, thank you very much for joining me, either in Zoom or Facebook. I hope you enjoyed it. We're going to have a recording posted shortly once it's ready and shared with the community of Bautanz. If you're not a member of our community, join us at bautanz.com. And you can find all of these, of course, separate practices in the book, It Takes You to Tango, the ultimate guide to tango training for leaders and followers. So, till next time, keep on practicing and enjoy your dances.